All right, so what we're going to do now is, in the same lab, we have just these VLANs. So let's add another VLAN, right? Let's this VLAN 10 right here. Let's just add another VLAN. Obviously, we got 20 and 30, so I got to make something else up. So I'm going to bring a computer, and let's put it on a different port. We're going to do port 2. We don't have to get all that creative. Port 2, right? We're configuring a LAN. But this time, we're not going to put an IP address. All right. We're going to set it up for something else. We're going for a DHCP server. All right. So let's just close that. Let's fast forward through time. So we've created, or we're going to create, another VLAN. So I'm going to copy paste this. Control C, Control V. And this will be 100. No, let's not get that carried away. So let's just do VLAN 60. All right, that'll be that. And let's label them so we know that is VLAN 60. So this will be VLAN 60. Okay, and then this will be VLAN 10. So we know. All right, just by looking at the labels. You need to create labels so you know exactly what's going on. So all right, so we need to create VLAN 60. So all right, so we need to go to the switch. We need to create VLAN 60 because we do a show VLAN brief. We have already HR. So we're going to do another one. So config T, VLAN 60. Name, faculty. All right. And then we're going to assign it to port 2. So we're going to go into interface F0/2. We're going to do switch port mode access. Switch port access VLAN 60. So let's verify that. Show VLAN brief to make sure that it is there. And it's assigned to that port. Lovely. And we got another VLAN right there. So let's put an IP address for that VLAN. So it's going to be config T. Interface VLAN 60. And we're going to say IP address 192.168.60.253.255.255.255.0. All right, do WR. So now the VLAN's got an IP address. The VLAN's assigned to an interface. Lovely. Now, we already have a trunk port, which is the only one here, but it's not enough just to create it. Now we need to go ahead and put in the sub interface to match that particular VLAN. All right. So we come here. Come here. Oh no. Bypassing that. Don't want to type in no username and password. All right, so we need to create now. Let's take a look at this so we know where we're at. Show IP and brief. So everything's on the G00 interface. So we're going to go int G0/0/0.60. Why dot 60, lads? Because it's the 60 VLAN. Is it required? No, it's recommended. All right, then we do the incap dot 1Q. That has to be the same, 60. And now we put the actual gateway address, IP address, 192.168.60.254.255.255.0, enter, do WR. So now, show IP in brief. So now we have two VLANs. They're both up. All right, we create the sub interface for that VLAN on the router. Like there's a router on a stick, and we have the VLAN created on the switch here that's attached to F02. We assigned that VLAN to this particular port. Everything is trunked, so we don't have an issue. We have one big issue, though, the fact of that we don't have a DHCP server. So now you know you can keep creating VLANs and keep creating VLANs on your switches. It's up to you if you want to do that. Small networks usually do that. They'll break the switch in half. They have two departments. Although, if you look at it physically here, these top ports could be, let's say, VLAN 1 or let's say VLAN 1, Milan 2, Milan 3, Milan 4, if that's what you want to do, it's up to you. If you have a very small organization, usually, let's say in a school environment, you have one switch, let's say per classroom. So every classroom would be a different VLAN. Let's say the number of the classroom, that would be the VLAN number for that particular switch. And obviously you give it a name. That's for the math, you know, whatever, or for however you want to name it. All right, it's complete. The naming convention is up to you, but the VLAN assignment, it's one VLAN per classroom, let's say. All right, one VLAN per department. If you're big enough and you need something like that, you do that. If you have a small environment and you want to break things out into separate VLANs, which breaks up broadcast domains, which decreases the amount of broadcast on your network and makes your networking more efficient, yeah, you can do that as well too. All right, but the issue now is that we don't have an IP address. We have an IPPO, and that's not going to work. That's not going to work. So what are we going to do? We can do it on the router, or we can do it on the switch. Now, this is a layer 3 switch, so we can go ahead and do it right on the switch. And that's what normally is done when you, nowadays, when you're in a big enterprise environment, the layer 3 switches, the access layer, or even distribution switches are the ones that are assigning IP addresses if you don't want to have a DHCP server. So when we come back, that's exactly what we're going to do. See you there.